it's kind of a bleak picture in some ways. You know, all the things we've been pointing out about where we're at in the world today, and the cultural milieu that we're in, and the challenges of the church, and the emptying of the church, and the lukewarmness, and all of this stuff. So what do we do? And you know, and I said I want that fire. I want to ignite a fire. I want a fire ignited in me. I want a fire ignited in others. But you know, how do we get there? And it really comes down to me. It comes down to, folks, you know, we've got to make a decision about what really matters, what's really important in life, what's going to make a difference for me, for my kids, for the future, because I can't keep living this way, because it isn't taking me really anywhere that God wants me to be. My dad used to like to say, you know, fish or cut bait. He had a more colorful way of saying that too. But it's time to make a decision. Where am I going? Where are you going? You know, I remember listening, overhearing a conversation years ago, a young person, high school student. Somebody was asking this young person, you know, well, what are you going to do, you know, with college? What are you going to do with your life? What's your career going to be? And this young person responded, I don't care as long as it makes me a lot of money. And I remember thinking to myself at the time, yeah, and then what? Is that all there is to life? No, there's so much more. There's hope for so much more. God wants so much more for you. He's holding it out to you. You got to make a decision. You can't just keep coasting along. I want people to know love. Real love. Not the counterfeits that are all over the place out there. There are all kinds of things that people call love that aren't real. There's only one love that's real, and God has shown it to us. And it's the only love that really is going to bring us the ultimate fulfillment and happiness. And I know that's maybe hard for some people to hear, but I think most of our experience is, yeah, these other forms of love fail. There's a love that doesn't fail. I've known it. I've experienced it. I know this love, and I want us all to have that love, and you can have it. You can have it, but you've got to make a choice. You've got to get off the fence, and you got to take action on it. You got to do something about it. We're all faced with a choice, a decision. There's a decision point to make it, that decision for Christ or not. Is this true or not? I can tell you that if you make the choice for Jesus, everything will change. Everything will change for you. It has for me. It has for so many people that I know. Jesus really does change everything.